All right, guys, another weekend of estate sales. You'll see me now, so I'm walking up on this house here. It's a really pretty house on the lake. It was like a one-story house. It was really big on the inside, but as you guys will see, it was kind of weird when we got inside. Let's check it out. All right, so we're inside the house here, but then you'll see this 2x4 holding up the entire middle of the house, and they've got lights strung up. The foundation gave way. She said it was abandoned for a couple of years. She said when they got there inside the house, the entire living room ceiling had fallen down from all the water damage. You guys can see the new drywall put up in there. Like, the entire kitchen had fallen down. She said the refrigerator was like laying on its side. It was a huge disaster. So in order to even have this estate sale, the family had to have a contractor come in here and make this thing safe for people to even be walking through it. Me and Allison were really taken by surprise, because we did not expect the house to be in this condition. When we walked in, it was kind of a weird thing to see. It was the first time for us. This was all like brand new in the box type stuff, or really good condition with the boxes, I'm assuming pre-owned. So there's a lot of brand new stuff, but it wasn't high-end brand new stuff, which is no problem with that. It's just, you know, with estate sales, sometimes they see it as new and they kind of price it up, and I think this was kind of the case here. There was a lot of new stuff, but it was kind of over our profit margin threshold, so you'll see me scanning a lot of barcodes, but nothing was coming up in the profit that we like to make. All right, so here I am. You'll see me walk into this little it was like a spare closet room, or like a laundry room, my bad. The camera really doesn't do it justice, but this room was like at a 20 degree angle. It was crazy. It was just completely leaning in towards the center of the house. The tile was all, you know, broken and felt weird underneath my feet. So I didn't spend a whole lot of time here. It just didn't feel safe, really. So as I was walking around, Allison had been on the other side of the house, and she came and got me and showed me all this. So this was some pretty good stuff. I ended up getting one thing out of here. A lot of the stuff was new in the packaging, but it wasn't really high-end stuff. So there you guys just saw me pick up some Sony over-the-ear headphones. These were moderately vintage, I would say 2010, thereabouts. There weren't any listed on eBay, and there weren't any sold. So since these were brand new in the package, I did go ahead and send these into Amazon. Again, I don't think they had a very good ranking on Amazon either, but I only paid like $5 for these, and I have them listed for $95 on Amazon, and they'll probably sit there for a while, but being that they're the only ones that are brand new, I'm fairly confident that they'll sell pretty soon. So here I'm going to pick up a tape eraser. So this would be for like video cassette tapes, not VHS tapes, but like camcorder tapes, maybe audio cassette tapes. So you would pass this through. It's like a big magnet, but this was in the box, and I went in and scanned the barcode, and there were a couple that had sold for like $30. I think this was $1. So I went ahead and grabbed it. In hindsight, I probably would have skipped that had I been finding a little bit more items at this sale. Since I didn't really have a whole lot at this point, I went in and grabbed it. One, because it was cheap. Two, because it had like a 50 or 60% sell-through rate. All right, guys, nasty toilet time here. Look at that sucker. That's gross. But anyway, here I am going into the master bathroom. I briefly looked at something on the counter, but then out of the corner of my eyes, I saw Hot Wheels Mountain. So I had no idea this was part of the sale. This was not listed on the estatesales.net posting that I'd looked at. My heart kind of stopped at this point. The deal with this was they wanted $3,000. And I think they kind of put the old stuff towards the front, so I was really excited because that would be a pretty good deal, especially since this was half off day. I was hoping that that would be a part of it. But as I started to dig deeper, the old stuff was at the front, and you've got a lot of sizzlers type stuff, which, you know, in the box, those are good, but you have to put all of that stuff together just to make sure that it's complete. Because if it's incomplete in the box, you're not really going to make that much on it. And the boxes weren't mint either. So I was like, okay, so I'll keep looking. I think at this point, Allison had come up. So we both got really excited. But as we were digging through, this was a lot of like early 2000s, mid 2000s, just single cards, like the mainline cars. They were all on the cards, but we're not seeing $3,000 worth of stuff here. And even if it was half off, which I don't think it was, definitely not worth it, unfortunately. I tried to justify it in my head because I really wanted to go through all this stuff once we got home. But, you know, after looking at in some of these sets, they weren't in the greatest condition. That tub down there you guys just saw was actually treasure hunts from the mid to early 2000s, which, yeah, they're treasure hunts, but they're not worth a whole lot. And like I said, with the sizzlers in the boxes and the treasure hunts, you're not going to justify that $3,000 price tag, unfortunately. So I had to walk away. All right. There was 6 of these games, all of them brand new and sealed. They were kind of stacked up. One was up top on this bookshelf. There was a couple underneath down in the cabinets. These were, I believe, like $4 or $5 a piece once it was all said and done. And I actually listed these on FBA since they were brand new sealed. I'm not expecting to sell a whole lot of them right now since Christmas is over, but you know, stuff like that does sell throughout the year. But if I do still have them listed around Christmas, I think that these are gonna sell really quick because board games are kind of like a universal toy for younger kids. So I believe I have them listed anywhere from $30 to $40. I think one of them is listed for like $43. There was 2 of each ones. I think there was a Battleship, a Mousetrap, and a Sorry. We got all these.
And then Mousetrap, that was a good game. Oh, I remember that.
You get to build your own on that one.
I'll do 40 for all of them.
Okay.
And then it'll be tax.
I've got a sales tax certificate.
Cool.
Can you go get that out of the car? Okay. It's been folded and put in my pocket many times.
You're fine. All right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, guys. Right. Here we are walking up to, I think this is the last estate sale of this day, actually. Some of the stuff in between was not great. So here we are jogging across the street. So this is actually a town that was hit by a tornado. This is like the historic part of the town, and a lot of these houses were severely damaged by the tornado. This one was not, but all around this house there was trees down and all that stuff. So this actually happened about a year ago, so it was good to see this area, you know, really getting back into shape, and really good to see that this house was not severely damaged.
That's nice.
So I spot these speakers sitting here. These are, I believe, indoor-outdoor speakers, wireless, I believe. I've sold these before, but I got a lot more money for mine back in the day. So I did not pick those up. But here, Allison has spotted something for me. She's very good at that. You know, I like her. All right, so I finally make my way over to the box that Allison pointed out, and immediately I see the Warriors of Rock Guitar Hero guitar controller. This is like an easy $50 plus on eBay, so that made the whole box worth it. I think it was $10 for this whole box, but as you'll see, the box was kind of just full of random Xbox and Wii type stuff. I didn't see any systems in this house. That was probably sold earlier, but this was just like the base for the Wii, which I always need, the little stand that it sits on. There was some AV cables in there, so a lot of good stuff that I can put with other systems, but nothing that I can immediately make my money back on. Alright, so here I spot what I thought that I've sold before. It's a Clarisonic Opal. It's like a little facial cleanser thing. I don't know, for like, I don't know what they do, but I have sold them before. I've actually sold the Clarisonic Mio, M-I-O. I've sold a lot of those before, and this is the Opal. I've never sold that one before, but I was able to make a good profit on this. I haven't sold it yet, and I also haven't listed it yet, but it was worth my time. I believe it was $4 or $5, and it came with the charger and some kind of little, accessory to that as well. But if you guys ever see the Clarisonic stuff, look that up, because the Mios are worth decent money and they're really cheap usually at yard sales. Whoa. Oh, this is the kitchen.
Yeah.
Out there. Like a pool house. Millions. So here we are in the basement slash garage of this house. You won't be able to see it on camera, but this place was like 4 foot tall. It was ridiculous. As you'll see, I instantly gravitated towards this Stiletto boombox. This is for the Sirius XM little radios. This one was in the box. It was not new, and it was actually missing the stiletto part of it, which was like a little MP3 player. But I did end up picking that up. I've got it listed right now for $80 on eBay. Probably need to lower that down a bit since it does not have the stiletto with it. But I think I can make some money on it. It was cheap. This actually was not in its correct box. I thought it was, but it was not. I looked it up, and working, they go for like $130 to $140, I believe, somewhere around there. And I actually did plug this one in the house, just because I've yet to learn my lesson on plugging stuff in. But I tried to do my due diligence on this one. It powered on. Don't think I pushed the eject button for the DVD player. And lo and behold, the DVD player doesn't work. But that's okay, because as you'll see on the screenshot, I already sold this thing for $46, $45, somewhere around there, plus shipping. So somebody, I'm hoping, is going to be able to fix this thing up. So everything else worked on this. The VCR worked fine, which is usually the culprit. These things, you know, have belts and stuff in them. They don't work, but this one worked fine. For whatever reason, the DVD player would not power on. It wasn't getting any power to it, would not eject, but it would make a terrible, terrible sound. So, like I've said before, don't worry about if things don't work, because you might be able to still sell them for profit. Before you guys just throw something away like that, look it up on eBay. There's usually a for parts are not working category selection to pick on the left-hand side. You guys can check that box and you will see all that are listed and sold for parts or not working.
Zombie flamingos.
So here comes Alice again here in a second. Oh, there she is. This is a brand new sealed Uno game from 1979. I have not listed this one yet, but these sell for like $20 to $30. So we went ahead and grabbed it. I think it was just bundled in with something else that we had. So we've got very little cost into this, and it actually had a pretty good sell-through rate. So here I was looking up a Delta Seville kitchen faucet set. These are usually always high-end stuff, sell for a lot of money. This one's no exception. If this was brand new, sealed in the box, this would be like $160. Unfortunately, kind of figured that it was missing something since it was open. But I went ahead and got it, and you guys will see here in a little bit, I actually got another one just like it. I was able to make a complete set out of one of them, and I will be able to sell all the other parts out of the incomplete set individually on eBay, which is something that I usually do. If you guys have any kind of, you know, faucet set that you come across that's not complete, don't be hesitant to pick it up, because usually you can sell those parts online for usually a lot cheaper than the OEM manufacturer, but you're still going to be able to make money on them.
$95.
Okay.
The $5 from the VCR.
Gotcha.
Everything else is all even numbers, huh?
Yeah, that should be $95.
Thank you.
Alrighty, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Alright guys, so that's another weekend of estate sales completed. Hopefully you guys enjoyed everything and learned a little something, if not a lot something. Right now, estate sales are not huge in our area. We are in Georgia, but it still does get cold here. So we're kind of, you know, there's a couple of estate sales here and there every weekend. In the spring, it's really going to pick up, and we hope to do a lot more. So let us know in the comments below what kind of videos you guys like. Do you like these videos where I narrate over the footage, or do you like it better when I have everything laid out on the table and we kind of do screenshots and I tell you about the items and whatnot? So let us know down in the comments, and maybe that'll influence our channel a little bit. See you guys. Okay.